In this lecture, we will talk about how to sketch a rational function. You see, this rational function upstairs is 2x squared minus 2x minus 84. Denominator is x squared minus x minus 12. The exponent of denominator, the highest one, is 2. The highest exponent for numerator is also 2. For this case, the step one is that we want to factor numerator and denominator. To factor denominator, we know negative 12 is negative 4 plus 3 times 3. 3 times negative 4 is negative 12. Add together is negative 1. So we know denominator can be factored into x minus 4, x plus 3. For numerator, if we pull 2 out, then we have x squared, and the middle term is negative x. The constant is negative 42, because when you multiply 2x squared, you have 2x squared. 2 negative x, then you have a negative 2x. And 2 negative 42, then you have a negative 84. Okay? You pull 2 out. That's a common factor. And then you have a 6 times 7, positive 6, negative 7 times each other, you have negative 42. Negative 7 plus positive 6, that's negative 1. So then you have x minus 7, x plus 6. Okay. So we factor out both numerator and denominator. The reason I'm doing so is because 0 points right here, you know, for denominator, x minus 4 gives you 0.4, because you plug in 4 here, 4 minus 4, denominator is 0. And here you have x plus 3 gives you another 0 point, which is negative 3, not positive 3, okay? Because you plug in negative 3 here, negative 3 plus positive 3, you get a 0. The reason I'm doing so is because if I find out 0 points for denominator, 4 and negative 3, positive 4, negative 3. Right here. We know denominator cannot be 0. Okay? If you find 0 points for denominator, that will be the vertical asymptote. That's why we have two dotted lines right here. Okay? Negative 3 and positive 4 are from here. That's step one. You want to figure out vertical asymptotes. Step two, you want to figure out the horizontal asymptotes. Remember here the degrees for both numerator and denominator, here the degree is 2. They are equal. To find a horizontal asymptote, you don't want to start with the factored one. You want to start with the unfactored one. Let's divide both numerator and denominator by x squared. You see, again, 2 is the highest exponent, and they're equal. So you want to divide by x squared. Why do I need to do so? You will see why right here. Let's figure out what we get when both numerator and the denominator divided by x squared first. You divide it by x squared here, 2x squared by x squared, you have a constant 2. And here x squared by x divided by x squared, you have a 1. And then 2x negative, this term divided by x squared, you have negative 2 over x. Because you know here is 1. You cancel 1x for numerator, you have another x down denominator. Okay. Similarly, x divided by x squared, you have a 1 over x. Because here you have a 1. You cancel x, then you have a 1 over x. For the constant, you just have a negative 84 divided by x squared. Negative 12 divided by x squared. Why do I need to do so? Look, here is the note. For x equals 10, you look at 2 over x, what do we get? You plug in 10 here, and 2 divided by 10 is 0.2. Okay? And then, if x equals 20, for 2 over x, 2 over 20 is 0.1. If x equals 100, we plug in 100 here, okay, 2 over 100 is 0.02. You can see when x gets bigger and bigger from 10 to 20 to 100, 2 over x gets 0.2, 0.01, 0.02, so gets to close to 0. Okay, when x is increasing as big as possible, you can see 2 over x close to 0. So, this basically tells us when x gets bigger, 2 over x goes to 0. How about 84 over x squared? That's probably the same. You see, 84 divided by x squared, when x is 10, you have a 10 squared, which is 100. 84 divided by 100 is 0.84. When x equals 20, you plug in here, 84 divided by 20 squared, that's 0.21. Okay, so this number is smaller than 0.84. When x equals 100, you plug in here, that's 100 squared, yeah, you have a what? 10,000. Okay, and 84 divided by 10,000, yeah, that's 0.0084, which is even closer to 0. So you can see when x goes bigger and bigger, both 2 over x and 84 over x squared goes to 0. Number goes to be smaller and smaller. Similarly, this will happen to 1 over x. When x is bigger and bigger, 1 over x gets smaller and smaller, 12 over x squared gets smaller and smaller. This basically tells us when x is bigger, those four quantities are very small, close to 0. So we only need to count 2 over 1 when x is very big. So when x close to infinity, we have the whole quantity is 2 over 1 approximately, which is 2. Because those four quantities are very small, you see here. X gets bigger and bigger, the whole quantity gets smaller and smaller. So when x gets bigger, we don't even need to consider those four quantities, only 2 over 1. This means when x gets bigger, the whole quantity is actually close to 2 over 1, or let's say 2. So a gets bigger and bigger means a goes to the positive infinity, And the whole quantity, or let's say f of x, actually here goes to 2. You see, the whole quantity is this one, is this one. So x goes to the infinity, f of x approaches 2. So then we have a horizontal asymptote. Later on, you don't need really to go through these processes. 2 over 2, 1 is actually from here, 2 over 1. So once the degree are equal for both numerator and denominator, the asymptote is actually the ratio of leading coefficients, 2 over 1. Okay? So in this way, you don't need to do that. So for horizontal asymptote, if leading coefficients are equal, then the ratio of the leading coefficient will be the asymptote, horizontal asymptote. So before we sketch the graph of f of x, we already know we have two vertical asymptotes and one horizontal asymptote. So we are done with step 1 and 2. And here is the note for step 2. Now let's figure out the picture. We know we have 0 points, because if you plug in 7 here, if you plug in 7, 7 minus 7 is 0. If one factor is 0, it crashes all numerator. If numerator is 0, you get whole quantity, or say f of x is 0. So we know 7, this point, is a 0 point. That means you plug in 7, you get f of x is 0. So basically here, 7, 0 is on the graph. Okay. Similarly, negative 6. If you plug in negative 6, what do you get? Negative 6 plus 6 is 0. One factor is 0. Whole numerator is 0. Whole numerator is 0. And then the whole quantity, or f of x, will be 0. So basically here you can see negative 6, 0, this point will be on the graph. Now we know in this quantity we have two 0 points for denominator, 4, -3, 4, -3. That's vertical asymptote. And the 2 0 points for numerator, yeah, that's the 0 points. These 4 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, will give us the 5 part. 4 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, divide the whole line into 5 parts. You see, one point will divide one line into left and right 2 parts. But we have 4 points, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then from here is part 1, from here to here is part 2, from here to here is part 3, from here to here is part 4, from here to the left is part 5. So you want to see among these 5 parts which one is positive, which one is negative. Then you choose the point to test. You see, the first part is above 7, so you may choose 9. Of course, you may choose 8. Okay, so let's choose 9. If you plug in 9 here, 9 here, you can choose this rational expression to calculate. We can choose also this one to calculate. Okay, so plug in 9, that will be 9 minus 7, 9 plus 6, 9 minus 4, 9 plus 3. Okay, so 9 minus 7 is 2, 9 plus 6 is 15, And 9 minus 4 is 5, 9 plus 3 is 12. Numerator is 60, denominator is 60, so the answer is 1. Okay, then you know when x is 9, y is 1, so 9, 1, this point. And you also know this is positive. So from 7 to the right, you find a point and which is positive. If y is positive, whole thing is positive. So you can connect this 0 point to that. Goes like that. It goes very close to the horizontal asymptote 2, but never touches it. Okay. Now, the second part is between 4 and 7. You can pick this point 6 to test. You can also pick 5. Here I picked 5. Okay. You plug in 5. And then you see here 2 times 5 minus 7. 5 plus 6. 5 minus 4. 5 plus 3. Okay. Now let's calculate. 2 times 5 minus 7 is negative 2, 5 plus 6 is 11. 5 minus 4 is 1, okay, 5 plus 3 is 8. Then you have a negative, only one negative here, so the final answer is negative. That's 11 over 2, which is negative 5.5. Then you have a x is 5, y is negative 5.5. So x is 5, y is negative 5.5. You see here was 5, negative, then negative 5.5 is right here. So you know on the right hand side of 7 is positive, you have this point. On the left, you have this point. If you connect it, that will be one branch. And you know this is the asymptote. This line can get close to this asymptote as close as you want it, but never touches this one. Okay. Then we have three more parts to analyze. We are done with this part and this part, and there this part, and this part. From this part, the middle part, negative 3 to 4, we can choose a very convenient point, which is 0, because 0 is between negative 3 and 4. Okay. You plug in here. Of course, you can plug in here. But when we see 0 here, we like to see that. 2 times 0, that's here. Yeah, 0 squared is still 0. 2 times 0, that's here. Minus 84, that's here. Denominator, 0 squared, so 0 squared. Minus 0, minus 0. Minus 12, minus 12. So then 0, 0 here, negative 84 right here for numerator. 0, 0 minus 12, so it's negative 12. So we got a positive 10 because they are both negative, which is positive. This tells us that third part between negative 3 and 4, when x is 0, your y is 7. So here is 0 and 7. Okay. Yeah. So 0, 7. 0, 7. Okay. Now, since you have one point in this range is positive, then rest all of them are positive. Since you have these two lines, a dotted line, asymptotes, you know the curve will going up. it will approach those two dotted lines as close as you want it, but it never touches these two vertical dotted lines. Okay. Now, then we got to study between negative 6 and 3, negative 3, and less than negative 6. You know, between negative 6 and negative 3, you can choose negative 5. I chose negative 4. Okay. Negative 4, if you plug in, then you will see negative 4 minus 7, negative 4 minus 4, negative 4 plus 6, negative 4 plus 3 is like the one we did here. Negative 7, negative 4, negative positive 6, positive 3. Okay, let's calculate. 2 times negative 4 minus negative 7 is negative 11. Negative 4 plus 6 is positive 2. Denominator negative 4 minus 4 is negative 8. Negative 4 plus 3 is positive 1. So 3 negatives gives us negative. And then we then have a negative 11 over 2, which is negative 5.5, less than 0. So we know that negative 4, then between these two, which we got negative 5.5. So then we have a negative 4, negative 5.5, you know this point. Again, one point is negative. Between these two, then all the points are below, are negative. Okay, so you can connect this 0 point with that. We know this 0 point right from beginning, right? You see, when we plug in negative 6 here, we get numerator is 0. One factor is 0. The whole factor, whole numerator is 0. Numerator is 0, whole quantity is 0. Okay? So then you can connect this one. And again, this is the asymptote. So this line can go as close as you want it to the vertical asymptote. And then, you know, from negative 6 to the left-hand side, you can pick another point. Here I picked was negative 8. Okay? You pick negative 8 minus 7, negative 15, negative 8 plus 6 is negative 2. You have a 2 here. Okay. And then you have negative 8 minus 4, that's negative 12. Negative 8 plus 3 is negative 5. Again, 2 times 2 is 4 times 15. You have a you have a 60 upstairs. Okay. And here 5 times 12 is also 60. So you got 1 because we have 4 negatives make it a positive. So then you have a negative 8 equals f of negative 8 equals 1, which is positive. Okay. So where is that? X is negative 8. X is negative 8. Y is 1. So it's right here. It's positive. Again, one point is positive from the 0 point, then the whole thing will be positive. You connect negative 6 with negative 8, 1. Negative 6, 0. Then you have this part. Okay. So right here, I think we are done with graphing of this function. There are 3 major steps. Step 1, factor denominator. Okay, factor denominator. You got vertical asymptotes, 0 points for the denominator. Now, if the step 2 is in step 2, if the exponents of both numerator and denominator is the same degree, then you can immediately find out the ratio 2 over 1, which is 2, will be the horizontal asymptote. If here again is both have a degree 3, you have the same. Okay, horizontal will be again 2 over 1. If here the exponent both are 5, then still you have a 2 over 1. Okay, it's always the case like that if the exponents are equal. You find out vertical and horizontal asymptotes, then you want to consider 0 points for both numerator and denominator. Okay, see where the sign changes. Normally the pattern is that if here you have all degree 1, you see degree is 1, degree is 1, degree is 1, degree is 1, then the sign alternates. It means from this point to the right, if it's positive, then between 4 and 7 is going to be negative. And then between negative 3 and 4 will be all positive. And then between negative 6 and negative 3 will be negative. And then less than negative 6 will be positive. It alternates. That's the pattern. If all degrees right here are 1. You want to choose the point to test. When you test those points, you can basically connect it. Because you are also to consider as asymptotes. So you can roughly sketch the picture. Okay? Please review these three major steps. And I'll see you next time.